Okay, I know. I'm only 14 episodes in, and I'm already breaking the rules of my own channel name by reviewing a TV show. Who knows, maybe next time I'll be talking about popular soap opera episodes I hate. But to distract you guys from all that, let me start off with a quick question. Do you guys enjoy movies like Ferris Bueller's Day Off? Do you enjoy movies like The Breakfast Club, The Virgin Suicides, Mean Girls, Booksmart, Lady Bird, American Pie, The Perfect Date, Tall Girl? Okay, bad examples, sorry. But are you seeing all of those and just wanting more? Well, there is! And it's been waiting for you the whole time, idiot, and you didn't even know it. And about 10% of you are nodding your heads, praising me for my endeavors, while the other 95 are asking questions about what the heck is going on.
Yeah, I don't think that's how numbers work.
Can you just shut up? That is why I am here to share with you possibly my favorite piece of cinema in this genre of films. And it is called Freaks and Geeks. Why? Why make a video on this when I could overcomplicate yet another pretentious masterclass in film? Well, maybe that's just because it's so easy to have a passion for something so charming and endearing when those quote-unquote pretentious films can be... well, you know.
His bath mats are gorgeous.
And yes, this 18-episode TV series is one of the most likable and endearing comedies to ever be put on TV in my mind. And it's not just because of the jokes, although there's plenty there. It is the characters. And honestly, I think Rowan Atkinson of all people says it best.
I mean, generally, I enjoy the performance more than the joke. I usually enjoy the performer and his attitude. You know, it's the attitude with which humor is told which I enjoy so much. In other words, generally, the things that make me laugh are characters. You know, it's people who kind of present a sort of truth to you. I mean, even though it's mad or it's funny or it's wacky or it's rude or it's silly, but there's a sort of a truth there that you identify with. And you think, I know that situation, I've been there, or I've seen someone like that on the train, or I am someone like that, and I prefer to keep it hidden. And yet here I am being characterized extremely well. And that does make me laugh.
Characters are what we find so endearing and attaching to film and TV. Without the character, without the face to deliver the joke falls flat. Let's be honest, we've all had that moment where you tell a joke a comedian made or a joke that you heard in a movie, and in your head it sounded way funnier, but when you actually say it, you both just sit there in silence wondering why you decided to tell the joke in the first place. It's the face that is able to deliver the joke that makes it so much more enjoyable. Even the most simplistic form of comedy by Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly works at times with Step Brothers and Talladega Nights because the characters established in the film. Even if they basically are just Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly. So take a series starring a kid who acts like he's always high and a kid who doesn't act like it but is in real life, two parents who just can and can't get enough of each other, one Jewish kid who... never mind, he's just Jewish, a psychotic maniac of a girlfriend, a guidance counselor who embodies the 80s, and finally a girl who has a stick so far up her own butt that she can't seem to know the difference between freaks and geeks. A recipe for disaster if you ask me. And I think that's why it works. For me, and along with all the other 15% that know how great this show is. So let me explain it to you other 90% of people who still don't know.
Dude, come on.
Yeah, okay, I get it. Personally, to me, I find Freaks and Geeks to be the story about just that. But not just the separation of them, but where they meet together in agreement. Despite it only having that 18-episode runtime in the first season, it's pretty clear where we can see the series going in terms of themes and character progression. Although what kind of made this show so great to begin with is the willingness to do the unpredictable. So maybe I just don't know anything. But it's that last episode, Discos and Dragons, is where I start to see the progression of what I believe to be one of the key characters, Daniel Desario. In my mind, he embodies the pieces of each and every character in the show. A kid who is stuck between what he really wants for his life and what he thinks he needs. A kid who may seem hard and tough on the outside, but crumbles within because of the oppression from his family, his friends, and himself. But the hope we see for him and hopefully others in Discos and Dragons shows that it doesn't have to be that way. Yes, some freaks will always be freaks and some geeks will always be geeks, but there will always be those who secretly long to be in between. Lindsay Weir, an ex-mathlete, competes to be different. Not different from all others, but different from who others expect her to be. Kim Kelly, that psychotic maniac I was talking about, wants to be more than what she was just raised to be. A person shaped by her surroundings, but longs to be
a lawyer or something.
Nick Andopoulos, a burnout, but also a kid who has a passion for drums and will stop at nothing to achieve his dream that no one says will come true. Ken Miller, probably one of the most underrated characters throughout the entire series, but a guy who never reveals his feelings because he is afraid of being judged. And I could go on about Sam, Bill, and Neil, but all they want is to leave their geek tendencies behind and kiss anyone with a set of lips and who is the opposite sex. All of these individuals are caught between two worlds, who they are supposed to be and who they really are. So the question is, will we ever be who we are? Or are we simply going to be caught flying through an endless abyss of who we're supposed to be? Truthfully, that's up to us. Even if every character that is shown throughout the 18 episodes doesn't become who they are, doesn't mean that they won't eventually get that chance. Daniel took the first step he had been longing for since the very beginning. And there still is a long road to travel, not just for him, but also us. But both of us will get there. Freaks and Geeks is a story of just that at its heart. We have to take the first step. We have to escape the thoughts and the mindsets of others, because truly they are not our own. And it might take a while to get there, but Freaks and Geeks can always be a lesson attested to that, because maybe Freaks and Geeks aren't so different at all. So instead of 10% of you truly appreciating the show, make that other 90% understand what it means not to have to be a freak and not to have to be a geek.
Yes, you got it!
Oh, never mind, that should be 85%.
Oh, you're kidding me!